Okay, we hear the day, people. I hope you guys having a wonderful Shabbat. I'm going to be talking about certain things today. I don't know. I was up this week. It was on my mind 2 days ago, I have talked about this subject matter about 2 or 3 years ago, I'm sure, on my channel, but the Lord got it back in my face again to talk about it with you guys again. So I'm going to be talking about what's your sign. Astrology is Baal. Astrology is Baal, Baal. And we're going to be coming from Isaiah 47 chapter relating to astrology and other things that Yeshua wants us to know at this time. And we're going to also be reading from Isaiah 13th chapter about coming out of Babylon, coming out of Babylon. So we got all these things going on around us right now with Israel. I haven't even looked at the news today. I know late last night they were saying missiles was going into Israel and ships and you name it. It's not cranking down, it's cranking up. So we need to be really praying for the situation over there, praying for America. I tell people if things happen in Israel, it's going to happen in America because we have so many Islamic people living here, and they are all waiting for the phone call, and they all have bombs scattered and things scattered all around as ATM, eight, I think ATM News was talking about it on his channel. A lot of people talking about it. So we need to be just watching and praying, people, keeping the blood over our doorposts. And so I'm going to go here now and just let my husband read from Isaiah 13. I'm going to be ending this today with the last judgment coming from Maranatha, the Lord is coming on page 339. And we're just going to talk Bible today. I'm not going to do no fancy anything else. We're just going to talk Bible. Speak from the Bible, talk from the Bible, preach from the Bible. And so, as I told you guys on my last video, all the prophecies are coming to pass that the old prophets talked about and prophesied on. And so all these things are coming to pass right now before us. So let me go here now and get over to Isaiah 13. I don't know if you want to change your background, but we're going to go here and read from Isaiah 13. And I think I'm going to say a little prayer before we get into it. Just Father, be with us today as we do this video in your name. We ask that your Holy Spirit touch us, be with us, speak through us. We bind Satan and all his evil angels away from us. We ask that your Holy Spirit touch us, Father, as we talk through the people about your word. And we thank you and we ask it all in the mighty name of Yeshua. So we're just going to read. He's going to read, and we're going to read and discuss as we go along. And you guys got any questions ever about any of these things? You can always email me, but I'm going to be talking a lot on the next chapter. I'm going to be talking on astrology stuff. And I'm telling you guys, I was into that once. I know what it's about. So, okay. So I won't be discussing that. So go ahead and read. We're just going to study over this chapter right now.
Okay, here we are. We'll start at verse 1, Isaiah 13, a declaration about Babylon that Isaiah, son of Amoz, received. On the bare mountain, set up a signal flag, cry aloud to them, wave your hand for them to go into the gates of the nobles. I have commanded my consecrated ones. Yes, I have called my mighty men to execute my anger, even my proudly exulting ones. The noise of a multitude in the mountains, as of many people, the noise of a tumult of the kingdoms, like many ethno-linguistic nations gathered together. Yahuwah of the heavenly armed forces is mustering the military force for the battle. They come from a far country, from way over the horizon. It is Yahuwah with his instruments of judgment to destroy the whole land. Howl, for the day of Yahuwah is near. That is a reference to Judgment Day, folks. It comes with destruction from the Almighty. Therefore, all hands hang limp, and every heart melts. They will be terrified. Pain and agony will seize them, like a woman in labor. They will look in astonishment at one another. Their faces will be aflame. Those are certainly references. There's Revelation, 12 there? And that sounds like nuclear warfare.
That's just like in New King James Version, it talk about a woman being in travail with child. So that's what it is.
See, the day of Yahuwah comes with cruel wrath and overflowing anger to make the land a desolation and to destroy the sinners from it. The stars of heaven and the constellations will not give their light. The sun will be darkened even from dawn, and the moon will not shine. I will punish the world for its evil and the wicked for their iniquity. I will put an end to the arrogance of the proud and will bring down the arrogance of the ruthless. I will make men more rare than fine gold and mankind harder to find than the pure gold of Ophir. Therefore, I will make the heavens tremble and the earth will be shaken out of its place by the fury of Yahuwah of the heavenly armed forces and on the day of his fierce anger. Like a hunted gazelle or like a sheep with no shepherd, every man will turn toward his own people and will flee to his own land. Everyone who is found will be killed and everyone who is captured will die by the sword. Yelch. Their infants also will be dashed in pieces before their eyes. Their houses will be plundered and their wives raped. Look, I am about to stir up the Medes to attack them, who will not be concerned about silver, nor do they delight in gold. Their arrows will pierce the young men. They will have no pity on babies and will not spare children. That sounds like the spirit of the age. Then Babylon, the most admired of kingdoms, the splendor of Chaldean pride, will be overthrown by the Almighty like Sodom and Gomorrah. It will not be inhabited or lived in from generation to generation. The Arab will not pitch his tent there, nor will shepherds have their flocks rest there. But wild animals of the desert will lie there. Their houses will be full of owls and ostriches, and wild goats will skip about there. Hyenas will cry in their fortresses and jackals in the beautiful palaces. Her time is near, and her days will not be delayed.
You understand the days will not be delayed. That's why I tell people, we can pray. We can pray, and we're supposed to pray daily, pray without ceasing. But as these things are coming before us, people, and the books of Daniel are opening, and John the Revelator and Revelation, the signs are showing and opening, it's no turning back. That's what I tell people. It's no turning back, because when a woman is in travail with child, you cannot stop in the mid-half section of it and say, well, let's stop here. It's going to continue until that baby is born. And so it's going on right now, people. It's happening right now. These things are going to keep escalating before us, okay? It's not going to go backwards, okay? We can't pray it away. It's just going to happen. So before, let me get on over here to... the other chapter, what is it called? 47. I really like this. I like the King James Version here, but I may switch over to the King James Version. You want to, let me see. I haven't looked at your this version, but let me go look down and make sure I can see what I'm looking for here. Okay, that's fine. It can stay here. That's all right. As long as it's not going to interfere with some of the other wordings here. The humiliation of Babylon, and I'm going to be showing some other things in relating to this one. I'm not going to run through this one real quickly like the other chapters, so just have to bear with me here. The humiliation of Babylon. Come down and sit in the dust, virgin daughter of Babylon. Sit at the ground without a throne, daughter of the Chaldeans. You know the Chaldeans was who, people, honey?
Babylonians.
The Babylonians, okay, was the Chaldeans back in the day, okay? You will no longer be called dainty or delicate. Take the millstone and grind flour. Remove your veil. Strip off your flowing robe. Uncover your legs. Cross the streams. Your nakedness will be uncovered. Yes, your shame will be seen. I will take vintage and will not spare a man. Our Redeemer, Yahuwah of the heavenly armed forces is his name, the set apart one of Israel. Sit in silence and go into darkness, daughter of the Chaldeans, for you will no longer be called queen of kingdoms. I was angry with my people. I defiled my heritage and gave them over into your hand, but you showed them no mercies. You placed a very heavy yoke on the old people. Okay. You said, I will rule forever as a sovereign queen. You did not take these things to heart, nor did you consider how they would turn out. So now, hear this, you who love pleasure and sit securely, you who say in your heart, I exist, and there is no one else like me, I will never sit as a widow, nor will I ever experience loss of children. And we're seeing it all over the day. Our children are being molested, raped, attacked, body parts being sold, this human trafficking, drug trafficking, sex trafficking, trade. Just awful, awful, awful. And we pray every night that they be shut down, caught, exposed, people. All our children are being under all kind of things going on, and it's going to increase. It's going to get worse. But these two things will come to you in a moment, in one day, the loss of children and widowhood in full force. They will come on you despite your sorceries and your many incantations and amulets. And you know what, people, all this stuff is sorcery, witchcraft. That's what it's talking about. This is all people doing today. They run into mediums and witches and oh, yeah, tell me my future. Tell me what's going to happen. And it's everywhere. I'm going to be showing you in a minute how it's happening right over in royal families. All over it's going to be happening. People are worshiping these false gods and idolatry. And Yeshua don't like it, people. He do not like it. Okay, so he said, you have trusted in your wickedness. You have said, no one sees me. Your wisdom and your knowledge lead you astray. But you say in your heart, I exist, and there is no one else like me. Oh my goodness. I thought the only person should have that title is Yeshua HaMashiach. There's no one else like him. Hallelujah. No one else like him, people. As the song say, I sing that song all the time. Who is like you, oh Lord, my God? Who is like you, oh Lord, my God? I lift up my arms to you, the Lord of my salvation. Nobody's like him. Nobody's like him. Karen Davis sing the song. Nobody's like him, people. Nobody. Nobody's like Yeshua, okay? But the people are going to say, oh, I exist and there is no one else like me. Well, you are nobody. You are nobody, world. You are nobody out there, okay? Disaster will overcome you. You will not be able to drive it away with your incantations. Destruction will fall on you. You will not be able to ward it off. Calamity will strike you suddenly before you know it. And it's already happening. People don't know one day from the next. They can get up and go out and never come back. Death can hit you at any time. You don't know what's going to happen. You need to be ready. You need to give your life to Yeshua HaMashiach today, people. That's what this sermon is about. Repenting. Stop going back to your dog's vomit. You know, stop going back. And I'm going to talk about this now. Persist in casting your spells and your many sorceries, which you have faithfully recited since your childhood. Perhaps you will be successful. Perhaps you will scare away disaster. You are tied out with your many consultations. Let those men stand up and save you, those astrologers with their horoscopes and stargazers and those who declare the months. Let them save you from what will happen to you. And let's stop here now and go over here real quickly. I was looking at this last night, and it's just so funny how the Lord showed me these things. Right in the time of when I need to have it come up. Turn away from astrology and the occult. The Bible warns us to avoid sorcery, mediums, and divination. God tells us to turn to him and renounce the occult. Many people, including Christians, think it's harmless to look at astrological charts, to engage in various forms of spiritualism. They think it is fun or entertaining. Others look to astrology, divination, and mediums for guidance, not just enlightenment. That's right. They go to these people for guidance. We shouldn't be going to these people for guidance, okay? I know years back in the day, when I was in my 20s. I think I was in my 20s, my late 20s or 30s. Because I was over in, I was living over near Wyoming at the time. And I was taking this class on astrology. it's got very fascinating to me. Wanted to know what it was about. And I took it and I learned how to look at the charts and read people's charts and all this stuff, people. And I'm just trying to tell you guys. And then Yeshua showed me that same scripture that I just showed you here from Isaiah 47, that you are not to be part of these things. You are not to be into these things. And so I began to wean out of it, wean myself away from it. And I'm saying wean myself away from it because it's so hard to get away from it. It's so hard to get away from it. Yeshua have told us to stay away from it. And so, you know, we need to repent if we are part of this stuff. We need to come out of it, people, because, you know, it's so hard to come out of it. It's so hard to come out of it. The devil make it so difficult for you to come out of it. And so you need to just always be repenting. I had to repent many days, many nights, many days until I just finally stopped looking at it, stopped listening to it. And I'm telling you, and Yeshua will clean you up from it. He will take you away from it. But I'm telling you, it's very demonic. It's very seducing spirits behind it. So you need to come out of it. So it says here, but God clearly warns against such practices in many Bible verses. Some reasons the scriptures warn against engaging in any form of the occult. We are opening ourselves up to spirits other than God's. We are not looking to God for guidance, but to the occult. We are turning away from true faith in Jesus. We are disobeying God's word, the Bible. Okay, so you can see you are totally sinning when you take part in these things. The Israelites often made the same mistake and turned from God, although God clearly warned them about this. When you enter the land the Lord your God is giving you, do not learn to imitate the detestable ways of the nations there. Let no one be found among you who sacrifices his son or daughter in the fire, who practices divination or sorcery, interprets omens, engages in witchcraft, casts spells, or who is a medium, or who consults the dead. And I know the dead is a big subject matter today. I was talking about this the other day. Every time Memorial Day come up, people put thousands and thousands of dollars in trying to appease the dead. Why are you appeasing the dead? The dead knows not anything. Why are you taking valuable, expensive flowers to graves of your family members every birthday, every holiday? You know, why people do that? All that money you should be given to the poor, given to the homeless, given to people in need, people who are alive, you know, not dead. But, you know, we do it. We worship the dead. We consult the dead. OK, we go and talk to the dead, going to the grave sites and talking to your parent, your dead relatives. People, we need to wake up. We need to wake up. OK, he say, we don't need to talk to people or consult the dead. Anyone who does these things is detestable to the Lord. And because of these detestable practices, the Lord your God will drive out those nations before you. You must be blameless before the Lord your God. The nations you will dispossess, listen to those who practice sorcery or divination. But as for you, the Lord your God has not permitted you to do so. And that's coming from Deuteronomy, way in the first part of the Bible, Deuteronomy 18:9-14, Israel's first king, and I'm not going to read, but this other little part of this, I'm going to put it in the description box for you to go read over this. This is very good information on here, okay? Israel's first king started out well. See, you start out well. You do. You start out well. You know, I thought about myself. I was a born-again Christian at 16. Started out well. And then you start getting all these things in front of you. The devil starts showing you all these things in front of you. And so we have to be very, very careful. That's why he said it's not about the beginning. It's about the ending. Those who endure until the end. That's what I want to say. Those that endure until the end will be saved. So it's not about your beginning. It's about your end, people. We need to learn to just endure, okay? So if we're doing all these things, we need to repent of them and stop doing them. Stop doing them. And I know sometimes we peeping, it's all over the place. It's all on the internet. It's all everywhere. You got astrology magazines. You got, you know, it's all in your face. You need to just don't read it. Don't look at it. Don't go there. Don't go there. Just say, Father, heal me, heal me, heal me, heal me. Get me out of it, Father. Somebody out there need this message today. I know he wanted me to preach this message today. Okay. So he says here, Israel's first king started out well. Okay. He expelled mediums and spiritualists from the land, then violated God's word and his own conscience by consulting a medium. See in 1 Samuel, go read it. His end was tragic, tragic. New Testament Christians turned from sorcery. Let the example serve as an inspiration and a warning. Many of those who believe now came and openly confessed their evil deeds. A number who had practiced sorcery brought their scrolls together and burned them publicly. I burnt all my astrology books, got rid of all of them, every last one of them back in the day. When they calculated the value of the scrolls, the total came to 50,000 drachmas. Drachmas, I don't know what that means. But in this way, the word of the Lord spread widely and grew in power. Okay, that's coming from Acts, the New Testament. These verses are given to us as warnings. God wants us to learn from the examples he gives in the Bible and to avoid making the same mistakes. He loves us and wants us to turn from anything that will get between us and the joyful life he offers. Okay. And so if you go read all these things, you can see all the verses that he got here. Bible verses warning about mediums and spiritualists. Bible verses warning about astrology. Bible verses warning about divination, sorcery, and magic charms. Bible verses warning about idol worship. Okay. God's love for you. So I'm going to leave this in the description box, a very well put together by Doug Britton from this Tree of Life thing. I think it's coming from Tree of Life or something here. But I want you guys to go, I will put it in the description box. DougBrittonBooks.com. It's coming from there. But let me go switch over here before I get back to the Bible. I want to show this to you really quickly. Okay. And I just had to shut this off because it was rolling too fast. But look at this. What are the royal family's star signs? Okay. This, you know what? This came up last night. I was talking to the Lord. I already knew I was going to preach on this. And he showed me this last night before I go to bed. Show me this while I go to bed last night. Zodiac signs who make great moms. You know, Mother's Day is coming. Rank from best to worst. And you know, Mother's Day actually came from the Catholic Church as well. I just have to say that to you guys. Okay. I believe in respecting my mom, and I do that, but that's where all these things come from, the Catholic Church. They appointed all these days, okay? And you always notice they own Sunday, the day of the sun, you know? That's why they want everybody to worship under the sun and the Sunday. And that's why I tell you guys, Sunday is not the Sabbath. And so, you know, you need to understand where all these things originate from, and then you won't probably partake of them, people. So let me go here and just read a little bit of this here. Do you know the zodiac signs who make the best moms? Sure, it's fun to do a ranking, but the truth is that every sign and every mother has their own unique style of mothering and their own special abilities at it. And even your horoscope can point out the best qualities you have for parenting. Now, you know, I'm not going to read all this garbage, okay? Zodiac signs is types of moms. And I'm telling you now, Yeshua already warned us in his Bible, in his word, to stay away from these things. Stay away. And I'm just going to put this, click this on. Let's read the caption up here. What are the royal family signs? And you know, this man, I told you, is like the Antichrist to me. And you know, see, the whole world going to be following after these things. Look at it. The whole world going to be following after astrology, sun god worship, all these things, people. So we need to stay away from these things. You know, Queen Elizabeth. All I'm going to be following after astrology, all this stuff. They do all this stuff, people. And so we need to be understanding how important it is to stay away. Stay away. Yeshua say stay away from these things. Okay, so I'm going to say Prince William. Look at there. I'm just telling you guys, it's coming. It's here. And that's what everybody going to want you to do. Bow down and worship these things. Bow down and worship idolatry. Bow down and worship astrology. Bow down and worship soothsayers. Bow down and worship witchcraft. Oh, come to me. I'm the medium. I can tell you the signs. I could tell you the future. You know, that's what they're going to want you to be into, these things, people. So we need to understand it's not good. It's not wise. But I thought that was very interesting. Very interesting when Yeshua showed me that last night. Very, very interesting. I'm going to take it off here now and go over here to my Bible where I was at. Okay. I'm telling you guys, it's just so important that we understand to not be a part of these things. Okay, that's fine. Fair enough, that's fine. Destruction will fall on you, okay? That's what it's saying. Where I was at down here. Okay. You are tied out with your many consultations, like I just showed you. Let those men stand up and save you. These men ain't going to save you. Those astrologers with their horoscopes, stargazers, and those who declare the months, let them save you from what is about to happen to you. Okay? And it's going to be devastation coming, people. We need to not put our trust in these things. Not put our trust in these things. See, they will become like stubble. The fire will burn them up. They will not save themselves from the hand of the flame. There are no coals to warm them and no fire for them to sit by. This is what they have become to you. Those with whom you have worked and with and who brought and sold with them when you were young, and all of them keep doing their own foolish things. And when you cry out for help, there is no one. What? No one. There is no one who can rescue you. And that's it. That's it. Okay. That's a very short, powerful chapter there, Isaiah 47. But he wanted me to share it with you guys. And I'm telling you, it's time to come out of Babylon. Come out of her. Come out of her. Stay out of her. Be out of her. So I'm going here now and look up November 27. I didn't even set it up. I thought I did. I didn't set it up. November 27. You see the title here, The Last Judgment. So I'm going to mute this out and let him play, and we'll end this for the day.
November 27th, The Last Judgment. I saw the dead, small and great, stand before God, and the books were opened, and the dead were judged out of those things which are written in the books according to their works. Revelation 20, verse 12. Now Christ again appears to the view of his enemies. Far above the city, upon a foundation of burnished gold, is a throne high and lifted up. Upon this throne sits the Son of God, and around him are the subjects of his kingdom. The power and majesty of Christ no language can describe, no pen portray. The glory of the Eternal Father is enshrouding his Son. The brightness of his presence fills the city of God and flows out beyond the gates, flooding the whole earth with its radiance. Nearest the throne are those who were once zealous in the cause of Satan, but who, plucked as brands from the burning, have followed their Savior with deep, intense devotion. Next are those who perfected Christian characters in the midst of falsehood and infidelity, those who honored the law of God when the Christian world declared it void, and the millions of all ages who were martyred for their faith. And beyond is the great multitude which no man could number, of all nations and kindreds and people and tongues, before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed with white robes and palms in their hands. Revelation 7:9. The redeemed raise a song of praise that echoes and re-echoes through the vaults of heaven. Salvation to our God, which sitteth upon the throne and unto the Lamb. Verse 10. An angel and seraph unite their voices in adoration. In the presence of the assembled inhabitants of earth and heaven, the final coronation of the Son of God takes place. And now, invested with supreme majesty and power, the King of Kings pronounces sentence upon the rebels against his government and executes justice upon those who have transgressed his law and oppressed his people. As soon as the books of record are opened and the eye of Jesus looks upon the wicked, they are conscious of every sin which they have ever committed.
Yep. All the books will be open one day, people. Do you want your book? Do you want your sins to find you out? Do you want your sins to find you out? Do you really want that to happen? The Sabbath day, called the Sabbath of the light, called the Sabbath of the light, the holy of the Lord, Isaiah 58:13. Remember, happy Sabbath. I know a lot of people say happy Sabbath, Shabbat Shalom. This is just English. Shabbat Shalom is Hebrew. But I'm telling you guys, it's time to really be about our Father's business. It's time to know that the days are winding down. The hours of the on the hourglass, you know, if you have an hourglass, the sands are coming through quickly. We need to really give our life to the Master today, Yeshua today. I'm going to just end this with prayer now. I'm going to read something coming from my little promise book. You know, all these things going on around us, and Yeshua don't want us to worry about it. He said, let not your heart be troubled. But he also said to have faith in him. As it says in Mark 11, 22, 23, have faith in God. Have faith in Yeshua. Have faith. Jesus answered, I tell you the truth, if anyone says to this mountain, go throw yourself into the sea, and does not doubt in his heart, but believes that what he says will happen, it will be done for him. And we need to understand that it's time to really trust in God. Go to him and have him to, and increase your faith, and know that we must fix our eyes on the Master right now. As it says in Hebrews 12, 1, 2, therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that so easily entangles, and let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us. Let us fix our eyes on Jesus, Yeshua, the author and perfecter of our faith, who for joy set before him endured the cross, scorning its shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Hebrews 12, 1, 2. It's time to really know that time is short, and we need to know that Yeshua said he have overcome the world. We can go look in the back of the book, and we know he have overcome the world. We know not to put our trust in man, not to put our trust in people, not to put our trust in this world. This world is dying. It's going to die more. It's going to burn. It's going to be just corrupted in every form, shape, fashion. So people, I'm here to just encourage you again. I try to encourage you on all my videos, encouraging you to keep looking up, to keep looking up, not looking down, not being sorrowful, not being doubtful, but to trust in the Almighty God who's coming soon. He's coming with all his holy angels. So I'm going to leave it there. I thank you guys for all the offerings that you always give to this channel, this online ministry. As we know, we use this online ministry to help people in all parts of the world, the homeless people, the fatherless, the motherless, the missionaries doing a mighty work. We need to be praying for India constantly, Africa, Israel, because we got a lot of things going on. A lot of policies are changing. So where people, Christians are being shut out completely. They don't want a Christian nation in India. They want Hindus. They want only Hindus. They even getting rid of Muslims. So we need to be praying for one another and knowing that we are going to be going through some persecution. A lot of people out there, I have to say this before I leave, a lot of people out there is teaching this pre-trib rapture. I do not believe it. I don't think the Bible support it. And I know if you go read Matthew 24, 29 to 39, you will see that. Yeshua say immediately after the tribulation, then these things in the sky will start happening. And he will come through the clouds, but it won't be before that time. And I just don't believe that. If you do your homework, you'll find you go way back in the 1600s. They was talking about this pre-trib stuff way back then in the 1800s, 1600s. And I'm telling you, people, read the Bible for what it says. Don't let people twist your mind. Don't let people put a book out and twist your mind. You need to read the Bible for what it says, okay? Because I think we're going to be going through some tribulational times. They're already approaching us right now. Tribulation's going on right now, all in many parts of the world. It just haven't increased in America yet, but it's coming. And we need to be ready for it. Ready. Give our life to the only man that can save us, Yeshua HaMashiach. Hinduism, Buddhism, atheism, Catholicism, all these things, astrology, Scientology, Allah, none of these things going to save us, people. Only Yeshua HaMashiach, the only one who can save you from this world is him. The only one can change your DNA from Adam's seed to his seed is him. So I'm telling you, it's so important that you do it today. So important that you do it today. You can always call us and talk to us about salvation if you need someone to pray with you into salvation. I'm going to let my husband pray now and shut this video out. So we thank you guys for watching, and I hope you guys have a wonderful, wonderful Shabbat. I like my other picture though, Shabbat Shalom. So I hope you guys have a wonderful Shabbat Shalom. So you can go ahead and close it out.
Father, we thank you. Hallelujah. For this video. Thank you for everyone watching, Father. Thank you for all our partners and donors and helpers, Father. Mm-hmm. Thank you for all the workers in your kingdom all over the world, Father. Mm-hmm. We thank you for them. Hold them up. Strengthen them, Father. Protect them from the enemy. Father, we look forward to Yeshua's return. Mm-hmm. That is what we're looking for. We thank you for your scriptures that you told us in advance what's coming.
Yeah.
And we just thank you that you're going to come quickly and soon. Yeshua, we look forward to it. Mm-hmm. We love you. Thank you for this beautiful day. Shabbat shalom. Amen and amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. So, guys, I'll see you guys in another video. Have a wonderful Shabbat. Shabbat shalom. Love you guys. Bye-bye.